Welcome to Pajama Prayers. It's so good to have you with me tonight. We have a great show in store for you. We have a new game of hidden pictures, and we also have a story from the Bible that you're going to absolutely love. So let's go ahead and get started with our hidden pictures game. Best of luck to you. Are you ready? Here we go.
Can you find what's hidden in this picture? Can you find a bottle? Where is the magnifying glass? What about a mushroom? Can you find a butterfly? Do you see a candle? Can you find a mitten? Do you see a crescent moon? Do you see a ladle? Where is the sock? Where is the star? Where is the mallet? Can you find an adhesive bandage? Do you see a toothbrush? Can you find a tennis racket? Can you find a whistle? Do you see a carrot? What about a ruler? Do you see a teacup? Can you find a banana? What about a ghost? Can you find the comb? Can you see a ring? Can you find the mouse? Now find the cherry. Can you find a boomerang? Can you find a radish? Where is the hot air balloon? What about a baseball? Do you see a cloud? Can you find a scarf? Great job!
Well, how did you do? I didn't do so well tonight. Sometimes I find a lot of them, but not so much tonight. Let's go ahead and move on to our story. We have a great story. It's found in the book of Jonah, and it is the story of Jonah. So settle down and enjoy the story.
Alice was a little girl who liked to sing and play. She loved her Bible storybook and read from it each day. She was reading Jonah's story, all about that Bible time, when an airmail bird delivered a note that had this little rhyme. Reading is the magic key to take you where you want to be. The book that Alice held became a giant magic screen. She walked on through to Bible land and came upon this scene. God was telling Jonah,
"I have for you a mission. Jonah, go to Nineveh and fix a bad condition. The people there are sinning. They don't know right from wrong. They need someone to warn them whose faith is very strong. They're strangers to you, Jonah, but help them mend their ways, or their wickedness will bring despair in only 40 days.
Thought Jonah, I don't like them. I won't warn them. I won't go. Why, I'd rather disobey and hide than help folks I don't know. So, Jonah tried to run from God. He paid to take a ride on board a great big sailing ship with space where he could hide. But Jonah couldn't hide from God, for God is everywhere. When Jonah hid beneath the deck, God found him there. God sent a wind that caused a storm that rocked the ship at sea. And all the sailors on the ship were as frightened as could be. Back and forth, the ship rocked. Well, it almost broke in two. So the captain went to Jonah and asked him, "What should we do?" Jonah said, "I ran away and disobeyed the Lord. Well, it's me he wants to punish, so you'll have to throw me overboard." The sailors didn't want to do as Jonah said they should, but the storm kept growing worse and worse, as Jonah knew it would. To calm the storm, the sailors had to follow Jonah's wish. So they threw him in the sea, and then God sent a great big fish. The big fish swallowed Jonah as he sank into the sea. Oh me, oh my, thought Jonah, what will become of me? Inside the fish's belly, all alone and scared he stayed for 3 long days and 3 long, long nights. Jonah prayed and prayed. Jonah asked God to forgive him for running far away, for Jonah knew that it was wrong to ever disobey. He thanked God for his mercy, and he thanked God for his care, and from the bottom of the sea, God heard every prayer. God had the fish blow Jonah out safe upon a shore. And God told Jonah he should go to Nineveh once more. Well, this time Jonah minded God, so to Nineveh he went, and he warned, "You all have 40 days in which you can repent." Well, the people there all listened. They repented, every one, and God forgave and spared them when he saw what they had done. But Jonah wasn't pleased at all, for Jonah had no pity and wasn't happy that he'd helped the people save their city. Jonah sat down in the sun, and next to him, God made a lovely plant that grew and grew and offered Jonah shade. The next day, God destroyed the plant that Jonah learned to love. And he questioned why God did this. God answered from above, "You felt pity for a plant that lived for one short day. Isn't Nineveh far greater than a plant in every way? That city's filled with people who were wicked and were bad. They were sorry and repented. And that made me very, very glad." Then Jonah finally understood, for in his heart he knew that God is merciful and wise, and all-forgiving too. Alice walked back through the screen and she put her book away and thought, I've learned 3 special things in Bible Land today. First of all, we must obey what God tells us to do. Then I learned that God's everywhere. We can't hide from His view. I also know that when we're bad and sorry as can be, God has mercy and has pity, and He forgives us lovingly. Then Alice said a silent prayer and thanked the Lord above for all the lessons that she had learned and for His endless love. The end.
Well, what did you think about that story, boys and girls? Have you heard the story before? I hope so. There are 3 things that we really learn from the story of Jonah. The first thing is obedience. It is always wise to obey. Obeying God, obeying your parents. Obedience is always a good thing. The second thing we learn from the story of Jonah is that you can't hide from God. God knows where you are all the time. The Bible says He is always with us. So He always knows because He's always watching over us. And that's a very good thing, boys and girls. The last lesson that we learn from the story of Jonah is that God forgives. I love that. When we make choices that are not wise, when we do things we shouldn't do, or we don't obey, we can just ask God to forgive us. And He's such a loving God, and He does forgive. Well, that's our show for tonight. I hope you have enjoyed it. Turn to someone sitting there with you and say, you are worth more than you know, capable of more than you think, and loved more than you can imagine. Good night.